Good evening and welcome to another episode of the Seneca Scout. I'm Cadence Kilhoff.
And I'm Emily Lopez. And well, you know what they say, third time's a charm, right? Well, not only are we bringing you another episode of Seneca Scout, but we're also bringing you the third episode of our show tonight. And on top of that, this is also the first maskless show in just 2 years.
As always, we plan to bring you local, national, and international news from our desks to your TVs and laptops at home. We know there is much to discuss with the Russian invasion of Ukraine, mask mandates, and COVID news, or about the new Kanye album that was just released. But here at the Seneca Scout, we aim to bring you stories that you may not know about. So, whether you're tuning in to hear about the bocce team at Seneca Valley or Britney Spears' book deal, this is the Seneca Scout. We begin tonight with a local news story that took place just about 20 minutes away from the Seneca Valley High School.
Mars Area Elementary School students had the ability to learn by dressing up as wax figures last Friday. These third graders dressed up as past presidents and president and first ladies, presenting the information and found about their assigned character to teachers, parents, and fellow classmates during the school day. This event has taken place for the past 18 years, but unfortunately didn't occur in 2021 because of COVID. The teacher behind the event, Jennifer McLellan, mentioned that the kids were very excited to participate this year and worked very hard on their research. The principal, Todd Labe, also supports the project, saying it gives all the children chances to learn more about historical figures in the Oval Office than they could have. McLellan had also stated that quote, "This is just a super good cross-curricular activity. We're learning about the government, so we decided to let them research presidents and first ladies. They had then take the research, form it into a speech, and how they presented it to the kids or to their families."
As we close out Black History Month, students from SV's Shout Committee are set to release a documentary film about the incredible accomplishments of several African-American Pittsburghers. The goal of the film is to both educate and draw awareness to the underrepresentation of Black voices in our shared history, especially local history. 13 Seneca Valley students lent their voices to a script penned by senior Vivian Palmer. We spoke with Vivian to give us more insight into the project.
So the idea for the video came from wanting to address Black History Month and the need to recognize that we need to go beyond just Black History Month in the integration of Black history into all history, because Black history is a part of history, and it's something that deserves to be spotlighted even outside of that month. So our goal with the video was, one, to have a PSA and say that here's why we need to go beyond the month, here's how ingrained Black culture is into our local community. And it was also to highlight that Black history in our local community in terms of Pittsburgh figures, and recognizing that history that so often goes unrecognized, especially in the school system and popular culture. In the process of writing the script, I learned almost how much I didn't know. It's so ingrained that you can't separate the city of Pittsburgh from its Black history. And I think that was the big learning point for me, just how deep that integration runs.
The film is now live on SVTV's YouTube page, on both SV Shout and SVTV social media accounts, and will be airing before and after the morning announcements next week as well.
Keeping within the theme of making a difference around our school, as the undefeated bocce team continues their stride through the season, we are taking a deeper look at their game highlights from last Thursday's win at home, as well as getting to know members of the team and why they love the sport.
During the past 5 years, the Seneca Valley Unified Sports Bocce Team has been giving kids with and without disabilities a chance to go show off and play a sport they love in front of their classmates and peers, just like every kid should have. This season has been nothing short of remarkable so far, as the team is undefeated. We decided to take a closer look at members of the team and get to know more about their love for the sport. What inspired you to start coaching for the bocce ball team?
Well, Katie Smolter, teacher over in the senior high, started our program 5 years ago, and I joined in the second year. So I thought it was an awesome program. Unified Sports takes our students with and without disabilities and pairs them together into a program where they can develop friendships and socialize outside of the classroom. So I think it's really important. I also feel like everybody should have the opportunity to be on a sports team. If it's something you've ever experienced, you know how rewarding it is. So we think that this is a great program and are glad to have it here at Seneca.
What do you love most about the bocce team?
Oh, it has to be all of my players. They're awesome. I love the returning players. I've had some now for 4 years, and we're really gonna miss them when they're not with us next year. But the bond that they all make together, the friendships that are developed, the little moments at the end of a match when, you know, obviously we win, we're undefeated this year, and the excitement that happens, it's a sporting event everybody should get to experience.
Well, my favorite part is playing for my team, making my team happy, and having fun. That's the most important thing.
Well, Jonathan said it best. The most important thing is to have fun. Thank you to Jonathan and Coach Wolford for helping us out with this heartwarming story. We hope you can make it to one of their next games as they make their finishing touches before the playoffs. I'm Jake Manson, reporting with the Seneca Scout. Thank you for listening.
Now, moving on to more sportsmanship, or shall we say, poor sportsmanship. At the end of the game on February 20th between the Michigan Wolverines and Wisconsin Badgers, a fight broke out between the two college basketball teams. What began as an intense post-game handshake line exchanged between Michigan coach Juwan Howard and Wisconsin coach Greg Gard quickly escalated to an all-out brawl that involved players and coaches from both teams. The madness broke out shortly after the final horn when Gard confronted Howard, who appeared to be slow to enter the handshake line just near the scorer's table. Gard physically stopped Howard from moving past him, and the two exchanged words before tensions rose in a hurry. Michigan coach Juwan Howard and Wolverines players Musa Diabati and Terrence Williams II were also suspended. Howard, who struck Wisconsin's assistant coach Joe Krabenhoft in the face during the altercation, won't coach in Michigan's 5 remaining regular season games and was fined $40,000. One player from Wisconsin, Jacoby Neath, was also suspended for 1 game after being a part of the brawl. This fight happened at the Kohl Center after Wisconsin won 77-63. This event could possibly have an impact on Wisconsin's chances with March Madness since they are ranked number 15 in the nation.
Now, of course, today you can never be too sure about your privacy or personal protection. And over the past few weeks, the IRS has been facing backlash over the facial recognition and biometric data collection. Both sides of Congress and privacy advocates have voiced concern with the IRS current systems of authorizing one's identity. Currently, the IRS requires you to take a selfie of yourself to verify you and who you say you are. And to securely be able to access your accounts, the IRS has proposed a short-term solution by allowing people to confirm their identity through a virtual interview. The IRS has been using the site called ID.me to verify the identity of taxpayers and the claim that the biometric data being collected is only stored temporarily and will be deleted, quote, over the course of the next few weeks. A lawmaker has called technology used by the IRS, quote, invasive. The General Services Administration has stepped in to help the IRS with the security standards. The IRS says that the goal is to fix this system and make logging in more secure after the 2022 filing deadline.
And to wrap up the night, we close out this episode with a national story that has been in the works for several months now. But to a certain singer, she has been working on this story throughout her whole life. Just 13 years after her conservatorship, womanizer singer Britney Spears recently signed a $15 million book deal to release and publish her new tell-all memoir to discuss the events of her toxic past. Of course, the notorious hashtag #FreeBritney has been prominent throughout social media posts for months to show support towards Britney breaking free from her father, Jamie Spears' conservatorship. This control over the star put her life at a halt as she had to relearn how to come across to the public and live a normal life as a celebrity, as well as affecting the custody status with her children. Quote, "I truly believe this conservatorship is abusive," Spears told the court. "I don't feel like I can live a full life." end quote. With all of this comes major publicity, though. Spears has been the topic of many documentaries, much like the famous Framing Britney Spears, that features interviews with lawyers, marketing executives, and family members to talk about the abuse throughout the star's fame. This week, Spears has not only announced that she will finally be buying her own house, but signed a book deal with Simon & Schuster in order for her to fully tell her side of the story. This deal was described as one of the biggest of all time, with a record-breaking deal worth $15 million. Even though it's still unannounced when Britney's memoir will hit the shelves, but you can check out Framing Britney Spears at any time on Hulu.
Well, that's all we have here at Seneca Scout. Thank you for tuning in into the third episode and supporting us while we cover some of the lesser-known local, national, and international news.
We hope that you all have a great night, and remember to be sure and tune into next week's episode to get all of the latest news here from the studio. To the beach, y'all. Let's go. All around the world, y'all know.